Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's take a look at the top 10 new features in macOS Tahoe. Now, if you see this video early enough, you're still waiting for macOS Tahoe to get released. But for most people, it will already be out and you can update to it. Either way, here are the top 10 new features to look for. The one that gets the most attention is the new design called Liquid Glass. And it changes pretty much how everything looks, although not really how much works. It just has a basic new design to it. Like any design change, you're going to get some people saying they hate it, some people saying they love it, and most people not saying either one, which is fine. The important thing is that this is the first unified design that Apple has released. In the past, macOS elements have made their way into iOS, iOS elements have made their way into macOS, and so on. But this is the first time Apple has really come up with a design and implemented it across all of its different operating systems at once. But this new design also comes with some new options. You can now go into System Settings and then go to Appearance, and there's some new things here. You can change the icon and widget style to theme your Mac. So default makes it look like before, but you can now switch to dark and notice how the icons in the dock changed. And also elements here in the left sidebar changed as well. You can also go with a clear look instead, like this, and clear can be dark or light, like this. For each of these first three, you can change the folder color. You can see the folder color there and it's default blue, but you can change it to another color like this, and the default folder color will change, and you can choose any color basically from some sliders. But in addition to that, you can go over to the tinted option here, and that will use that folder color for more things. So, for instance, I could change the tinted color to red, and notice how not only do the folders change and the sidebar buttons here, but also other icons as well. And you have more options and could choose from more colors if you want. Now, in addition to changing the default folder color to something, you can also change individual folder colors. I can choose the folder here and then control click, right click, or two finger click on it and select customize folder. And then I've got the option here to change the color. It's actually using tags, the tags that are applied here and pulling the color from them. And it can use any one of the finder tag colors to change the color. In addition to that, you can also change the icon that's on a folder. So by default, there's nothing there, but you can choose something else from this list of objects and other icons. You can also click on emoji down here and then choose an emoji character and use that on the folder. So there's lots of ways to customize folders to make them stand out. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, nowhere is Liquid Glass more on display than in Control Center. It's no longer really any kind of window. It's now really just these floating glass buttons above your desktop. And in macOS Tahoe, you could customize Control Center. At the bottom here, you'll see Edit Controls. Click that, and you have this whole interface here for finding new controls. And if you find something you want to add to it, whether it's just a button or some sort of larger feature, you can drag it into one of these slots. You can use the minus buttons here to remove things or just drag things to change their order in Control Center. So there's a lot you can do to get the functions you want now in Control Center and remove ones you never use. Now, a big new change in macOS Tahoe is that there's no more Launchpad. Launchpad has been removed and it's been replaced with a new aspect of Spotlight. Most of us use Spotlight to launch apps before anyway, and you could still do Command Space and then type the name of an app and launch it that way. But in addition to that, after you bring up Spotlight, you can do Command 1 and it goes to a list of applications. When you search now, it's only going to find applications, or you can just scroll through them yourself or use one of these categories here to find what you want. You could also get to this by launching Spotlight from the menu bar. And you'll see these buttons here. You can click this one or use Command 1 at this point to go to the applications list. Another new part of Spotlight is a clipboard history. So instead of Command 1, you would use Command 4 or click this button here, and you get a history of your clipboard. Text, images, and other things will be saved here. and you can just click on something to insert it where you are. Like if you're working on a document and there's a piece of text, you can click here to copy it to the current clipboard, or control click, right click, or two finger click, and perform a variety of other actions on each individual item here. This means for most people, you won't need a clipboard manager anymore. Third-party clipboard managers will still have a lot of advanced functionality that this doesn't have. But for the basics, you can just use this new feature of Spotlight. And as you can tell, Spotlight has had a major overhaul, and another aspect of it is this third part here, the command 3 part that goes to actions. And this gives you a variety of different actions that you can take in Spotlight. So you can select one of these by, say, double-clicking on it. And then if there's more information, you would fill it in. So you could type a message and then type recipients and send a message right from Spotlight. You could also assign quick keys to anything you want. So for instance, if you wanted to have create note be assigned to CN, I could do that. And now I can bring up Spotlight, type CN, and you can see that'll be the first hit there, and then return. And then I could type in this case, the contents and the folder for the new note. There are a bunch of new apps that come with macOS Tahoe. For instance, there's the Journal app, which is the same that's been available on the iPhone, but now you can do it on your Mac and it'll all sync over iCloud. But in addition to that, there's a new app called Phone. And this connects to your iPhone and allows you to do things like, for instance, make phone calls on your Mac through your iPhone. You can also access your list of calls and voicemails through this app as well without having to get your iPhone out. Perhaps the most powerful new feature of macOS Tahoe is in the Shortcuts app. So in the Shortcuts app now, you can create automations. Automations are just regular shortcuts, but they are triggered not by you actually triggering the command manually, but by something like the time of day, an alarm going off, receiving an email message or a regular message from somebody, when stuff in a folder changes, kind of like folder actions in Automator. There are a whole bunch of different triggers here for automations, and then you can have these perform certain actions or link to existing shortcuts. And finally, another new app is the Games app. And the Games app ties together all sorts of aspects of gaming, kind of what we had in Game Center before, but now this will also list things that are in Apple Arcade. If you're a subscriber to that, it'll show your complete library of purchased games, including iPhone and iPad games that you can play here on your Mac. And you can launch them from here. You can manage them from here. You also have ways to play against other players and challenge others with scores and things like that. So a lot of different aspects of gaming, especially the casual games, found in the App Store and in Apple Arcade can now be managed here in this new Games app. And there are a ton of smaller features available throughout macOS and the apps that come with it. I'll be taking a look at these 10 new features and some of the smaller ones in upcoming videos. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.